والصلاه والسلام على رسول الله وعلى اله وصحبه اجمعين. الحمد لله, it's a wonderful day, it's a nice unity. Tanzeel, Palestine, one body, move from here to there, from here to here. Some people go memorize the Quran, some people come to look after memorizing the Quran to see Islamiyat and other knowledge and everything. So alhamdulillah, in the same place, wonderful place, wonderful school, wonderful masjid, all in one. That's a unity day that inshallah we want to share a khatira together. Since we are helping one another for good, then we need to remember something about choosing the right person or having the right person to help you for good. Today I want to tell you a story about a king and a minister. And one thing in common they have is they always together. The king and the minister, his minister, always together. Anywhere they go, they go. But sometimes you have good person with bad person, or weak believer with strong believer. And that's what we have a situation here where the king is someone who is good, but he's not that good. There are some flaws in his creed, in his aqidah, in his belief in the qada and qadar, the predestined. The minister, on the other hand, he's very strong in his aqidah. The pillars of faith are well established. Aqidah, in particular, qada and qadar, very strong. Meaning that whatever happens, he's happy all the time. And that's what a Muslim's supposed to be. A good Muslim's supposed to be happy all the time, even in sad situations, happy inside. Doesn't mean that if you're not feeling good or if you are aching, that means you're not happy. Inside, you're content, you accept it, you don't complain. So the minister is like that. Whatever something happens, we always say, Kullu khair min Allah. Everything from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is good. Well, the king has a habit of every Friday he goes out. And he enjoys his Friday, the picnic, and he comes back. One day before he leaves, he was doing something and he cut his finger, literally cut it off. While he was in the midst of pain and bleeding, the minister saw it and he said, Kullu khair min Allah. It's all good from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The king was furious. I am in despair, bleeding, and you're talking it's good. I tell you what, take him to jail. He commanded the guard and took the minister to jail. On the way to jail, he said, Kullu khair min Allah. It's all good from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Time passes. The king went on trip. Nearby, a jungle. While he was there, curious just like everybody else, want to check it out, took a little walk inside the jungle. And guess who was there? Some primitive people, ignorant people, like pagans. They worship idols, and they have celebrations. And during celebrations, they have to sacrifice something for the idols. That's what the shaitan dictates on people. When he overwhelms their mind, he changes everything. He makes them do everything haram and make them look like they're doing something good. So, he captured him. He was alone, doesn't have a guard. Took him and want to slaughter him, sacrifice for their idols. As usual, when you want to do something or give a gift for someone of high status, someone you love so much, you want it perfect. looked at the guy, investigated him, checked this out, four figures. Only four figures. How can we give a sacrifice to our God, a person with four fingers? That's a defect. Can't do that. Let him go. He was so happy and so excited, running, boom, it dawned on him. Wait a minute. That's what the minister said. Kullu khair Allah, all good. When I lost my finger, he said, all good. Sure enough, it was good. I lost a finger, I could have lost my eye. But because I lost a finger, they did not kill me. I feel bad. So he went to the minister, took him out of jail, and he told him, you know what? This is what happened to me. And I remember when we said, all of the good from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, now I understand what kullu khair min Allah. Now, because without it, I would have lost my life. The minister said, yeah, you're right. That's the meaning of the ayah, وَعَسَىٰ أَن تَكْرَهُ شَيْئًا وَهُوَ خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ. Maybe you hate something that's really good for you. He hated losing his finger, he hated the pain, he hated the bleeding, but in reality, it is wonderful. If they gave him the choice, all in there, kill you or cut your finger, he's going to choose cut my finger. But I have a question. The king told the minister, but I have a question. I understand kullu khair min Allah for me. But I don't get it. When you were going to jail, you also said kullu khair min Allah. What is so good for you going to jail? The minister is such a well-knowledgeable person. Happy, just like the Tanzeel people. Look how happy they are, mashallah. And I smile, look at the smiles and the beautiful face of the Allah. He was such a happy person because he accepts what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decrees for him. He knows the real outcome is good regardless. Because we are rewarded when we say Alhamdulillah, right? And we are rewarded when we are patient. Patience, in fact, the reward for it is so big, only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows how much. The angels don't know. The day of judgment, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala called patient people in front of everyone, and he gives them the reward that no one can expect. So the minister said, I said Alhamdulillah, and if you don't understand why I said kullu khair min Allah, you know I'm your best buddy. And you know anywhere you go, I go. Well, you got your finger. Who's with you? Me. I'm going with you. If you went inside the jungle, I'm going to go with you. And we don't need each other. And if they captured us, what will happen? They will let you go, and they will make me. But because I'm in jail, I can say, kullu khair min Allah. Can you say it? Kullu khair min Allah. If you work so hard, and you study so hard, and you don't get the grade that you want, that's your response. Alhamdulillah, kullu khair min Allah. Maybe if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave you the grade that you want, you become arrogant. Or you forget Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Maybe because you have a bad grade, now you remember to make dua before you start. Or now maybe you remember that you did something bad and maybe that's the reason why you got a bad grade. So you fix yourself. That's why Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us in a hadith, عَجَبًا لِأَمْرِ الْمُؤْمِنِ إِنَّ أَمْرَهُ كُلَّهُ لَهُ خَيْرٌ. It is a cause of wonder, the affair of the believers. The believer's affair is all good at all times, bad or good. In asabat wa sarra shakar wa kana khayran lah. When good things happen, alhamdulillah. And that's wonderful and rewarding. Because the Rasulullah said, the best dua that you can do is saying Alhamdulillah. Wa in asabathu darra, something bad inflicted him, sabr, patient. Wa dhalika khayrun lahu, and this is good for him. But Talha, pay attention. Wa laysa dhalika illa lilmu'min, and this affair, at good times, Alhamdulillah, at bad time, patient, only believers have that quality. Real believers. Weak believers, when they have bad time, they complain to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, why me? Why did you do this? I could have. I did. I worked. You complain, and you don't say Alhamdulillah, you're not patient. But believers, Mamun, if you think of believers, believers are cool. See, when you do this, fresh air, cool. You're cool, are you cool, man? You're not cool, you're cool. Believers are cool. They're so easygoing, so smooth. You convince them, they confess. If they don't like you, they will not harm you. And if they like you, they're so wonderful to you. At all times, believers are good. Good to be with, good to talk with, and good at the end, the day of judgment. That's why Prophet Muhammad said something about munchies. You like munchies? Food, Sheikh. Who doesn't like food? He said, لا تصاحب إلا مؤمنا. Only hang around with good people. And who are good people? Believers. مؤمنا. ولا يأكل طعامك إلا تقي. And you only feed your food, يعني the people that you invite and the people that you hang with, تقي. Good, righteous people. Yeah, behind the level of faith. Because, Sheikh, if I invite you, a man, if I invite you to my house and you are a good, righteous person from wonderful ISI, you're going to say, Alhamdulillah. And you're going to tell to Sheikh Hassan, Jazakallahu khayyah. Meaning, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you, the smallest reward I give is multiple times of this whole universe, because the whole universe is not equal to the mosquito to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he's going to make that dua for me. But if I invite someone who is not righteous, what does he do? Good food, man, yeah. Yeah, man, that was good. I never eaten something good, yeah, brother. And then he opens the door and goes, what did I get? Nothing. Nothing. Not even in this dunya, not in the hereafter. That's why, my friends, find the right person to be with and stick to that person. And if you have to pay a good person to be your friend, do it. Ask me how. I can't hear you. How? Today is lunchtime. Pizza is wonderful. I like, for instance, Ikram. I want him to be my friend. Ikram is not really pleasant. You know, I try to come with him, talk to him, and just mind his business and go. I go and say, Ikram, here's a pizza, man. It's for you. No, take care of it. And you give him pizza. Ikram is a believer. He's a righteous person. He appreciates it so much. And then he starts talking to you little by little. And he's your friend. So you really pay him in a worthy way. Because taking care of a person or feeding or being generous is rewarding. That's how you pay him. It's not like you say, okay, here's an amount of check. I'll just be my friend, okay? I'll call you tonight. Doesn't work like that. Before